And now, it's time for the Thamesmen.
It's like Chris is in training.
He's like a little.
Yeah, I know. He wants to do that, but he's just like,
you know. After a couple of hundred videos, we don't give a damn anymore. Like, do we look stupid? Yeah, kind of.
I'm doing it. I'm just off camera.
He's got really long arms. They're huge.
Oh, dear. Well, hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Thamesmen, the light reaction, high value entertainment channel. And today we've got a very honored guest.
Yeah, me. It's nice. Thanks, man. That's very kind.
I was wondering who it was. Yeah.
Yeah, well, honoured is a bit of a stretch. Ladies and gentlemen, as you can tell, over on the right hand corner in his convict outfit is Chris. Hello, Chris, the curator.
That's a beard, though. It's not a convict outfit.
I'm George. I'm in Los Angeles.
Chris, you want to?
I'm Chris. I'm in Melbourne.
Excellent. And I'm Alex, and I'm in San Francisco, and we are the Thamesmen. And end of the year wrap up, isn't it?
It is. Second time round.
No, it is second time round for the final year wrap up, but it is going to be three programs. But I like that one. We do that again. George, why don't you explain what we're doing to people?
No, because Chris is going to cut me down. He's going to cut me down to size, and I'm not going to take it.
That's not what you said last night.
Boom, boom. I've got a joke for you guys. I was just thinking about it.
Is it about the specials?
No, I'm not going to do that.
That's really inappropriate.
I've got one about the zookeeper. But anyway, that's...
All right. So what we're doing is but just before Christmas, we did the 12 biggest bands on the Thamesmen, and we thought that in between Christmas and New Year, it's a time for reflection and healing.
Mm-hmm. And we decided to just each of us pick a track from the last year, not the whole last 2 years, but the last year that we thought was really special and we really liked, and we wanted to just hear it again. And so yesterday or whenever it came out, I did the Them Crooked Vultures with New Fang. And we're going to have a little poll, and I think it's going to win, obviously, because it is such a great track. But then today, I believe it's Alex's moment. So, Alex, tell us about your thinking and how you got to where we are.
It is. And the poll is only representative of how good music taste you have, right? So I do wish you luck there, George. And I'm so glad you didn't put Mason Jennings in.
Well, I would have done Mason Jennings, but Mason Jennings was 2 years ago, so he fell out of the category. Otherwise, he'd been up there. Oh, yeah,
dear me. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is this was actually introduced to us by Chris. So obviously, Chris is Australian, and we got to know Chris through the Thamesmen, just like, you know, just bouncing back and forth. Anyway, so one of the bands he introduced us to was Chisel. And he said, look, check this band out, Cold Chisel. I said, yeah. And he passed us over Bow River. And it's been the top track for me for all year. And I tell you, there's so much going on, so many different elements. First of all, super, super tight, just genuine band. And, you know, no razzmatazz, just straight up there, just straight rock and roll, good pub band. And then different elements come through. First of all, you've got Mossy on the guitar and his vocals. And then just when you think you get to grips with that, the fucking harp player goes mad. Right? And then just when you think you've had enough of that, Mossy does this great solo on the guitar, which is wonderful. And then Jimmy Barnes comes in and smacks them all to the moon and back. And that is a whole package. Absolutely blew me away. Chris, obviously they're in the Australian culture, but when did you first find Cold Chisel and where do they sit in the Australian music scene?
Well, they've kind of always been there for me. There's never been a time when I was old enough to listen to music properly that Cold Chisel wasn't being played on the radio. And so I just kind of accumulated you know, that love of them from everywhere. I will give you one interesting story about seeing Jimmy Barnes solo, where I went along with my at the time girlfriend, ex-girlfriend, I should say, and the crowd are cheering for Chisel. Chisel, Chisel. And my musically ignorant ex said to me, "Why are they chanting for Cheezels?" Which are tasty Australian snack, you know.
And are they still played a lot? Are they still like relevant in Australia? Or is it just sort of us older folks who are harking back to a glory times of a great band, or do they still have a place?
I think on Australian radio, I'd dare I say there's probably not that many that play rock music any longer. I think it's fair to say that they do still get played on those radio stations that play rock music.
Right.
But I think, you know, Jimmy himself is still very prominent everywhere. So I think he's still kind of on everyone's radar at this stage. Yeah, I mean, we're all fading away.
Would Chisel be getting back together and ever doing another tour or shows or as Cold Chisel?
I think so. I mean, Jimmy's just had an operation fix his back because, as you may notice, he leans forward when he sings a lot.
So he climbs up things and throws himself into the audience and other stuff like that,
So, but, you know, once he's better, he's mad keen to, you know, he's one of these people who doesn't sit still. So he's keen to get out there, and I imagine they will definitely get back together. I'll hit you with a quote of his from the first time they got back together when he said, 10 minutes of playing and we wondered why, you know, we ever broke up. Yeah. After an hour of playing, we wondered how we ever got back together.
Well, I think we're going to listen to Bow River, and it's live, and I think that the only way I can sum up this band is like it's the band I would like to see most out of all the bands we've done. It would be the band that I would like to be in if I could be in any band here. And it's also, they all seem so down to earth. It's a band I'd like to hang out with and chat to out of everyone that we've seen. And as such, I think they're just such a well-rounded pack that, and I think this shows them off. And watch out for that harp player because I think he's slightly mad on amphetamines, but let's do it.
Yeah, I forgot about the harp player.
Oh, yeah.
When you said harp earlier, I was thinking like...
No, this guy's on one.
I can't remember a harp in this track.
Well, I remember this harp, and I'm just thinking, no, I hope he doesn't have he's going to have a harp attack.
Oh,
no.
Not just a pretty...
Call my agent.
All right.
Right. Fight me in my trailer.
I want my money back. I'm not working with these buffoons any longer. All right, let's do this. Everyone got it lined up?
I'm all lined up. Get your headphones.
Have you got your headies on? Headies on.
Get your headies on.
See, cultural appropriation. All right, you ready, Chris? Ready? 3, 2, 1, boom.
And listen now to the rain. I feel that water licking at my feet again. And I don't want to see this child no more, wasting my days on a factory floor. The first thing you know, I'll be back in my river. It's the first thing you know, I'll be back in my river. It's the first thing you know, I'll be back in my river again.
Released from the heart, man. I forgot how great
this
was.
Oh, brilliant.
Oh,
Oh, my gosh. That was...
Oh, God. I'm going to have to vote for your bloody song, aren't I?
Well, as I said, it's just down to your taste in music. But, you know, if you want, you know, if you want, I'll vote for you if you vote for me, just to be fair. That was just killer. Absolutely killer.
I forgot how good that was. So good.
Have you seen them live, Chris?
Yes, a few times. It's always a great show.
I bet it is. I could imagine being like, not in like maybe that in Indorthor, but like at a festival and like outside with like 100,000 people and that track coming on. And I can imagine it being a wild time.
I can imagine being in a smaller venue in a pub when it's slightly dark and you're quite drunk on very cheap, rank lager, but having the best time of your life with your mates and they put that on and it's just like, I'll vomit and then go up front. Sorry, Joe.
Actually, we had that earlier track we did of theirs. I think it was like what, it was a Manly Vale Hotel. I think it was. Yeah. And one of the comments someone wrote in and said that their family had owned the Manly Vale Hotel, and like it was sort of stories of like, you know, held together with like, you know, baling twine or something like that.
You got to like that track because we. Jimmy picked us up and put us on his page. And well, Colm Chisel. Jimmy. So, you know, it's the least you could do, George, you know, for Jimmy and the boys, you know.
I think you went for the easy votes. You know,
Jimmy's gonna come and smack you in if you say that. And you know he will, because he'll just punch you through the internet. You cannot have a go at that track. That is an absolute and it's like the all time you know what chord is coming next. You don't have to guess. It's like it's pre-written. You know, as soon as they say, you know all the singing lines and before you've even heard it. It's like regurgitated food.
It's like, what are you, a seagull? But I like the fact that it has that, and you could obviously, you muso types can give the proper
the walking bass line, the step bass line.
The sort of the descent.
Yeah.
Where he goes, da, 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 that, and they keep repeating that descent.
Yeah.
And I love that. That is such a great hook, you know.
Chris, is that...
And that's not predictable. That's something different, I think.
Chris, is that your favourite Chisel track?
I think of a live version, yeah, that would have to be easily the best.
Well, that was the track that turned me on to them. And for me, just for me, best track of the year.
Yeah.
Put it to the vote, and we're doing Chris's track tomorrow. Put it down there, and if you also think that my track is the best track, then just vote for me. If you think George's track is the best track, then vote for George, and then I wouldn't even bother with Chris's.
And if you think Alex is pandering to the audience, choose George or me.
I'll tell you, I'm going to get a big old ham. Because that's what we are, my dear. All right, we got to bounce. We'll see you tomorrow for Chris's track.
Don't forget to like and subscribe while you're here, please, because you want to see what's coming up next year.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, see you for Chris's track. Ciao. Oh, ciao. That was Italian. Avvino.